Welcome to WebStylePress. If you are new here, consider subscribing and hit bell icon. Operating systems like Windows, Linux or Mac come loaded with fonts. I am using Windows and here are fonts available for me to use. I can use any font from these in webpage using font family in CSS. This is HTML page that I've got. I have got Bootstrap linked with it via CDN.js. I can use it if I want to, and I have got custom.css style sheet linked with it. Then I have got a heading and a paragraph. This is my CSS with font family, and here is the page output. If I don't use any font family, web page will pick up default font, that is Times New Roman. As you can see here, if I use Twitter Bootstrap, it will pick up font family defined by Twitter Bootstrap. CSS offers font family property. You can name a font in font family like this Verdana. I have got Verdana font in my system right here. And here is the output. Now the font family is Verdana. You can also specify multiple fonts in font family, like this Verdana, Geneva, Sans Serif. Verdana is font family name here. Geneva is alternative font in case first is not available. And Sans Serif is generic family. In this font family, code editor is displaying font name Geneva in gray color. This is because I don't have any font named as Geneva in my PC. So whenever you use a font family, this is a good indication of font being available or not in your PC. So instead Geneva, we can use Georgia or any other font. In font family CSS property, if you use font that is available in PC, that will be loaded in web page. What if you don't have that font in PC? Suppose you are creating a web page. Designer provided you PSD or XD file that is using a font not available in your PC. You can ask designer to provide the font. You install that font and web page will display it for you. But you are not the only visitor of your site, and your website visitors may not have that particular font installed in their PC. So how will you use a custom font that will be loaded with website? Doesn't matter where website is being viewed. In this video, I will show you how can you define a custom font in CSS, how can you use custom font in web page, how can you link to a custom font that is not in your PC. I am going to download two free fonts, Leto and Neonato Sans. You can go to fonts.google.com, search these fonts and download it from this button given here. You don't need to download Google Fonts though, because you can link Google Fonts anyway. For example, select this font and here's the style sheet that you can link in your HTML document and use this font family to use this particular font. So you don't need to download Google Fonts. You can link to these fonts directly and you can use these fonts remotely. But for tutorial's sake, I am downloading these free fonts so that I can show you how font file can be used to display custom font style in web page. if you download this font, all of these styles will be downloaded. Each style has got its own font file. I selected only regular and bold versions of these fonts, and I have already downloaded these in my fonts folder here: Lato Bold, Lato Regular, Nuneto Sans Bold, Nuneto Sans Regular. So suppose you have these custom fonts that you want to link in your web page. To link font file, we use font face rule in CSS. Preferably define font face at top of your CSS file. Font family that you're going to use. Source, that will be the URL of font file. Font weight, font display, swap. So for our URL, we have got fonts in our fonts folder, and name is latoregular.ttf. .ttf is extension of that font. The font face rule allows custom fonts to be loaded on a web page. Once added to a style sheet, this rule instructs the web browser to download the font from where it is hosted, then display it as specified in the CSS. Without this, designs are limited to the fonts that are already loaded on a user's computer, which vary depending on the system being used. We have got these four fonts: Lato Bold, Lato Regular, Nuneto Sans Bold, Nuneto Sans Regular. Let's create font face for all of these. So second face will be Lato again, and here we will use this bold, Lato dash bold, and then font weight will be bold, and here Nuneto Sans. Nuneto Sans Regular. Nuneto Sans Bold. And for the name, font family name, let's use Nuneto Sans. So these are two font faces for same font, that is Nuneto Sans. This is the name that you can pick as you like. Like you can name it Nuneto custom font, and you can then call this font family and it will work. Important thing is this source URL for the font file, and then this weight. Now that I have defined font face for font files available for me, I can pick up the font family from these and use in my CSS. Like I can use this font family Lato here. Save. Refresh. And now font family Lato is being used. You can further specify sans serif for this font family, like this. Like you can see from here, if you select a font, you can specify sans serif in front of it as a generic family. And for Nuneto Sans, sans serif will work. Now I can use this font family here. And it will work. If I want to use Lotto's bolder version, I can just use this font weight here. And my page will reflect the changes. If I use Neonetto, this will work as well. So this is general idea. You download font files or you get the font files that you own, and then you keep it in your project. Then you can use font face to create font families by using font file source URL, and then you can use that font family in your CSS anywhere. This method is great, but I have another flexible method for you. You can enhance cross-browser compatibility for your custom font. Use any font face generator tool. Search font face generator tool and you will find many. Upload custom font file, get CSS and converted font files to use in your website. For example, this is a font face generator. Add your font files here. I am adding these four font files in .ttf format in this tool. You can specify font formats like TTF, WOFF, WOFF2, SVG and EOT. These additional file formats will help in cross-browser compatibility. Font face generator tool will take font files from you and will convert those files in additional file formats to enhance cross-browser compatibility for your font families. So after you select the formats, hit convert button and you will be presented with this download link. This is the downloaded file. Extract it here and you will get the CSS file along with all the converted fonts. Now copy all of these fonts, paste it in fonts directory, open the style sheet file in code editor, and you can see additional file formats for this font linked here. .ttf, .wwf, .woff2. Copy the style sheet and I'm replacing these styles now. I'll just have to take care path for this file, and this file is located in fonts folder. Just make sure path is correct for font file. Now I have got font family Lotto, similar font family Lotto. Only variation is this font weight bold here and font weight normal here. And for Neonetto Sans, the variation is font weight bold and font weight normal. Let's use this font family, Neonetto Sans. refresh the page, and as you can see, font family and Auto Sans. Let's use Lotto. With font weight bold. Refresh. And now it is font family Lotto, font weight bold. If this path is not correct for these fonts, then console will give an error that file not found, and it will name the files that it could not find. Also, with converted fonts, you get this HTML page. You can open this page and you can see the styles here, and CSS is also given here. So you can use font face generator that is easy to use. Upload your custom fonts, select format types for font files, convert these fonts, download the whole archive, and then extract fonts, style sheet, and HTML document. Place these fonts in your fonts directory. Use style sheet that came with it. And this is how you can link custom fonts with your HTML page. If font face does not work, check font file path. Use font display property and use swap. This property will help to load fonts smoothly. Initially, default font will be used from web browser. When custom font will be loaded, text style will change. So swap helps in user experience. That's it. I hope you liked this video. If I missed anything, comment down below. If you haven't already subscribed, subscribe to this channel and hit bell icon to receive updates. Join us on social media. Links are in the description below. Stay tuned for more updates. I will see you in the next video.